Le Covid a énuméré énormément d'inégalités sociales et d'inégalités en santé. Et donc, beaucoup ont des situations sociales très précaires.
The problem really in this phase is access to food. So people won't have access to food because they are losing their jobs. Basically, we're losing 10 years of improvements in poverty reduction because of COVID-19.
Aujourd'hui, l'histoire du Covid, c'est un prétexte pour dire voilà, cause de ça, Renovama, Alliance et suite.
Let's not forget that the pre-COVID-19 world was far from normal. Rising inequalities, systemic gender discrimination, lack of opportunities for young people, stagnant wages, runaway climate change.
90% of the jobs that will be had by our young children or grandchildren simply don't exist today. What we are certain of is that it is going to transform the way in which we are organized, the way in which work is organized.
The only thing I hear people talking about who wants to be president is how they're going to save all the coal miners in this country or get rid of all the coal miners in this country. We want our health care plan saved, and if you can't do that, and it's been 10 years, how do you think we're going to believe that you're going to be able to give us a just transition from the coal industry to some other employment?
Jobs will be lost as well as gains, and the new ones will not always be available to the same people, in the same place, at the same time as the jobs lost.
But in the same way that no economic growth can be good if it does not reduce inequalities, no ecological transition can be positive if it leaves people behind.
Discussions que j'ai eues avec les responsables d'entreprise, avec les représentants du personnel, sont de ce point de vue-là extrêmement intéressantes. Une des réponses, c'est l'investissement dans la formation, dans l'outil de production. Ce sont eux qui vont permettre à cette entreprise de passer les étapes qui sont devant elle.
American manufacturers have actually added nearly a million jobs in the past 7 years. The problem is those jobs require specialized skills. Festo is doing more than looking for workers, it's training them.
Now, I still think that there is an opportunity here to turn this crisis into something positive. This is also the right moment for governments, for businesses, and for workers themselves to invest in their reskilling and retraining.